Chapter 14, Regression Analysis in Finance. Introduction. Chapter 14 explores the concepts of correlation and regression analysis in finance. These tools are essential for understanding the statistical relationship between variables and making predictions based on that relationship. The chapter focuses on linear regression, a widely used method in finance, and the correlation coefficient, R, which measures the strength and direction of the correlation between variables. Excel or other software is typically used to calculate the correlation coefficient and perform regression analysis. Learning objectives. By the end of this chapter, you should be able to 1. Understand the concepts of correlation and regression analysis in finance. 2. Calculate and interpret the correlation coefficient to measure the strength and direction of the correlation between variables. 3. Use linear regression to predict one variable based on a different variable. 4. Test the assumptions for linear regression and interpret the results. 5. Explain how to interpret the slope of the best fit line. 6. Explain how to generate a prediction using a linear regression model. 7. Determine if the sign of the correlation coefficient will always be the same as the sign of the slope of the best fit linear regression model. Key points. Correlation analysis helps determine the statistical relationship between two variables, while regression analysis can be used to predict one variable based on another variable. The correlation coefficient measures the strength and direction of the correlation between variables. Linear regression is a common method used in finance to predict one variable based on a different variable. Excel or other software can be used to calculate the correlation coefficient and perform linear regression analysis. It is important to test the assumptions for linear regression, such as linearity, independence, and homoscedasticity. Real-world application. One real-world application of correlation and regression analysis in finance is portfolio diversification. By analyzing the correlation between different stocks or assets, investors can determine how closely their returns are related. A portfolio with highly correlated assets may be more risky, as the assets tend to move in the same direction. On the other hand, a portfolio with assets that have low or negative correlation can help reduce risk and increase diversification. By using regression analysis, investors can also predict the expected returns of a portfolio based on the historical performance of its individual assets. Conclusion: Chapter 14 introduces the concepts of correlation and regression analysis in finance. These tools are essential for calculating risk, predicting sales, and diversifying portfolios. By understanding the correlation coefficient and performing linear regression analysis, you can gain insights into the relationship between variables and make informed financial decisions. Testing the assumptions for linear regression is crucial to ensure the validity of the analysis. In real-world applications, correlation and regression analysis are used to optimize portfolio diversification and predict future returns. By mastering the concepts and techniques covered in this chapter, you will be equipped with valuable skills to analyze financial data and make informed decisions in various financial contexts.